Look, insurance sucks. I just make it suck less.
All right, what's going on, everybody? It's Brad Hannon here. We're switching it up from the Daily Debrief today. The Daily Debrief is great. Love to just brain dump my day on you. But today it was literally accounting and spreadsheets and commissions and, you know, stuff that I really can't even put into words. So we're switching it up to something that's been on my mind lately. And from kind of like a heart of wanting to share with maybe you're newer in the industry, or maybe you've hit a little bit of a ceiling in the industry, or maybe you're just flat out bored and ready for the next challenge or the next build, like, you know, I constantly am. And these are three things that I wish I would have done 5 years ago, right? So three things that I wish I would have done 5 years ago that I wouldn't necessarily say that would put me ahead of where I am currently, but it certainly would make things a whole lot easier as far as where I am currently if I had focused on this 5 years ago, right? And so the first thing, this is gonna sound a little bit contradictive to you, is started smaller. What do I mean by that? I mean that the industry as a whole, as the insurance industry as a whole is so centered around this, you know, making six figures. I'm guilty of it myself. We've got content out there, how I made my first six figures, how I went from six figures to a quarter million, whatever it was, right? I'm guilty of it myself, chasing that carrot, right? But what I mean by started smaller is, I mean that I wish I would have started 5 years ago, right? With, you know, making $60,000, $80,000, $100,000, and then stuck at that income, meaning, let's say I made $120,000 my first year in insurance, right? I know for sure that I can do $120,000 or more the following year. So if I'm a new agent starting out and I achieve that level of six-figure income or close to, or better yet, if I know that my bills can be met with $30,000 a year and I can live off of another $30,000 a year, I would literally cap myself at 60,000 bucks and I would bankroll every single dollar over and above and reinvest in the business. So starting smaller means, when I say starting smaller, I just mean with my own, you know, personal income, my own personal finances, because there is a massive difference between the commissions that you're paid and the gross and net revenue to your actual business. When you start to build a business, right? When you're a one-man rodeo, I know it can be easy to spend every dollar that comes in, or count every dollar that comes in towards your income, but that's not necessarily the reality, right? So if you start year one making $60,000 and you can pay yourself $60,000 for a couple of years, but you net far above that, let's just say $100,000 a year over that, you are literally going to have $300,000 or, you know, something close to that in the company bank account that you can really start to grow and scale your agency. Knowing what I've done in six short months here with Signature Medicare, with a half of that $300,000 basically, I know that if I would have planned better for the big home run, right? For the big, I spent a ton of money on the business, right? But being able to hit that huge home run by having a nice nest egg, it's a whole lot easier, right? When you do have that nest egg. So I wish I would have started smaller, bankrolled more money into savings, into whatever. And I'm not a big proponent of saving. So I'm not trying to sit here and tell you like save all your money like Dave Ramsey, right? I'm saying being able to reinvest it in your business. And it could be that you pay yourself $60,000, right? You hire an assistant for $20,000, you hire another appointment setter for $20,000, and now you can really start to build a business because you've got employees, right? So I'll do a deeper dive on that another time. But the second thing, and this kind of ties into the first point, but learn the business side of it. Learn the economics, right, of the actual business, because now it's what drives me. It keeps me up at night. It's got me, you know, looking at spreadsheets all day. I'm loving understanding the P&Ls, the balance sheets, where we're at exactly, our cost per acquisition, our cost per lead, you know, the all-in cost per acquisition when you factor in keeping the lights on in this place, and how we can grow and get it better and get it down. And, you know, all of these things are much more gamified than just selling a policy, right? Like, and I'm not knocking, like, if you're out there selling policies right now, these are the steps, really. These steps, these three things that I wish I learned 5 years ago, are almost, could almost be relabeled as like three ways to get yourself out of selling and into, you know, building a business, right? So learn the, you know, economics of it all, right? Learned, you know, maybe just meet with an accountant, maybe meet with, maybe you know somebody that runs a successful business that's not in insurance, that is a numbers person. They can break down business by the numbers. Get a book, right? Get on YouTube, do something, but to educate yourself on the actual economics of, you know, running a business. And I mean, you can go down a deep rabbit hole there. And then lastly, the third thing is spend more time learning the marketing side, right? I always use paid marketing. So third party, or, you know, never really spent a ton of time running my own Facebook ads or, you know, any of that stuff. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't be, you know, doing some of that. What I am saying is that I wish I would have just focused more time and energy and effort on learning that marketing side versus just buying leads and selling, right? Buying leads and selling. Now, I say all that to say, when you're talking about marketing anyways, you still have to generate business, right? So, like, again, being able to live within your means, understanding the economics of the business, and then lastly, focusing a little bit on marketing. If you do all of these things in conjunction over the course of 5 years, you can accomplish a massive feat, right? Like building a real business. So one of the things that I'm now so driven by, okay, just to kind of land the plane and bring this all home, when I started in insurance sales, I started in insurance sales because somebody told me that, hey, we're building something special, we need leaders. And I said, well, that sounds like something I like building. Great, I love that, right? I love the challenge of recruiting and building and growing an organization. Number two, I love leadership, right? I love getting better at leadership. I love having other people rely on me, drives me to be better. I love bringing people up. I love seeing people improve. So kind of, to bring this all home, these three things are things that now I'm very passionate about leading others and helping others accomplish these things. So growing an agency, building an agency, you know, learning the marketing side. We've got a cool platform we're gonna roll out for independent agents too, where you can tap into some different lead sources and things, you know, kind of at your leisure, more so, because that's the problem with independent agents. It's like, hey, we can send you calls, but when are you working? Well, depends on the day, right? This is a kind of a way to overcome that, which we've had trouble with in the past on my independent side, right? Because let's just face it, after you've reached a certain level of success, you're probably not working a strict schedule. Although I would argue that you should be, you know, I do, so you should be, but many people don't. And I also understand that. So we're launching a kind of a marketing platform. I'm actively looking for people to build agencies alongside of us, right? So all of these things are the things that will propel me to the next level, right? And so, sure, it's easy to look at it in hindsight and say, these are things that I wish I would have done more of, but I was already doing a lot as it is, right? Learning how to sell, learning how to recruit, then learning how to train those agents to sell. There was a lot that I was doing at that time, but if I could have just had, you know, one eye open towards some of this stuff, or, you know, somebody, a mentor in my ear saying, hey, listen, you're great at sales. I'm extremely proud of you, the way you're selling. You're great at recruiting. You're awesome. You're doing great. You're great at training agents. Now you've got agents that are under you that are selling well. That's incredible. There's still so much more beyond that. And I think that there's not enough people in the industry talking about this too. There's not enough there's not enough people that are teaching agents how to build real businesses, teaching agents the marketing side of things, or giving them access to you know, their own kind of done-for-you marketing that doesn't suck, let's just face it. And so these are the things that I'm passionate about that are helping to take me to the next level. So don't look at it as like, these are the things I really wish I would have done differently and, you know, poor me. It's more so just, man, if I knew then what I knew now, and I'm sure in another 5 years, me and E-Dub are going to be recording another video like this where I'm like, hey, these are three things that I wish I would have done differently or better. And if you don't look back at the last three years, five years and say, here's some things that I could have done better, I'm going to do these things better moving forward, you probably end up getting stuck. So you should do it too and really analyze you know, the things that you could do to make you better, whether it, you know, pains you to look at it or not, focus on getting better. And these, for me, are three things I wish I would have done differently over the last 5 years.
I'm a health insurance hustler. Bradley Hannon's the name. I'm here to teach these agents how to play the game. I'm a health insurance hustler. One thing you should know about me. I'm a health insurance hustler. Bradhannon.com.